all right and ready to go, if that's all right with you. What did you think of the service today? What did you think of today's dedication?
Well, this, from my point of view, is a 75th anniversary in the dam tree, which has been my main function. As the last British dam buster, I feel quite thrilled to be able to go to that, have that celebration this morning. And then to find I was invited to 97 Squadron Reunion, which is the squadron I first started my operations with. Back to Woodhall, a rather different Woodhall from what it was then, but still the same old place. And yes, it's been a great morning. And the sort of thing which we'll all, both will be associated together, 97 and 97, that's the way you're there. And I find that talking about 97, when I first started my operations, really brought back so many memories and pleasant ones too. But it's a sort of thing which this sort of day is really, I think, made for. Remembering all the things that you might have forgotten, but you will actually never forget. And that's very true on both occasions. 6.7 and 97.
How important is it to have these stones so that when people come and visit the nature reserve, they realise the history of the place?
Sorry?
How important is it to have memorial stones like this one so when people come, you don't know the significance of what this area
is? I think it's extremely important. And that's why I think these memorials, I think the most personal one is the new IBCC at Lincoln, where it's sited by the cathedral, right by the cathedral, and when you're coming back from the operations, if you got to the cathedral, you were home, and that was it. And with all those names on those walls, nearly 58,000, they always be there. That will be home to them in name. I think it's the greatest tribute to the Bomber Command of any of the Northerns, even the Green Park one. That's great. But this, I think, is far more personal and really gets the heart of the Bomber Command.
And Johnny, firstly, how different is Woodhall Spa now compared to how you remember it?
I wouldn't recognise it, quite frankly. I think these concrete bits might still be originals, but I'm not sure about that either. But it's great to see a memorial here. At one stage, I was given to understand it would be a Gibson memorial. But I can't understand that. I don't quite realise why, but I don't recall Gibson ever being at Woodhall. Collingsby, yes, but never at Woodhall. That's fine. I could be wrong, but there we are.
And Johnny, in some ways, has Woodhall Spa not changed at all as well? In some ways, has Woodhall Spa not changed? No, it's all right. And what's it like to have so many people come out today?
Great. It's still this recognition. And I'm quite surprised at how much over the last 3 or 4 years the World War II effort has increased in popularity. And strange enough, really among the younger people too. And I think that's absolutely tremendous. And I find our junior school, some of them, are teaching World War II history. And I've been asked to talk to several of the schools, junior schools in our area. And I'm amazed at the interest in the children's eyes when they come into the room. That makes it to me to start with. And when I finish talking and ask for questions, the hands go all over the place. Where the hell do I stop, you know? But all the questions are sensible, to the point, realistic. There's nothing facetious about it at all. And to me it means they're learning something about why the country they're living in is the country they're living in and what it might have been had things gone the other way. I think it's an essential part of their early education. I think
Is there anything else you'd like to say? I think you covered it as always.
I have to be careful here at my However, now I think just thank you for the interview. Thank you for being able to be here today and have this great day with the two squadrons, the unions, and look forward to the next one.